Join me today for a fantastic journey on the Vistadome coach of the Yeshwantpur Mangalore Karwar Express. Our journey would take us across the Western Ghats with some breathtaking views from the Vistadome's viewing gallery. Indian Railways introduced the Vistadome coaches to promote train tourism, and it's a very good initiative indeed. The two Vistadome coaches of this train are attached to the rear of the train and provides a wonderful rear view as the train moves along. Enjoy this brief preview now with the music, and then the full video with the description will follow. So we are now today traveling on the 06211 Yeshwantpur Karwar Express via Mangalore. The journey of 357 kilometers from Yeshwantpur to Mangalore is covered in 10 hours, average speed of 40 kilometers per hour. And we pass through the Western Ghats from Shakleshpur to Subramania Road, a distance of 55 kilometers, which we cover in 3 hours. And there are two Vistadome coaches in this train, EV1, EV2, each sitting capacity of 40, and you feel as if you are inside an aircraft. Now let us see the facilities that are available on this Vistadome coach. As you enter the coach, you have the wash basin, dustbin and a nice mirror on the left side, and there are two Western style toilets, and there are only two Western side toilets per coach. And this is the luggage rack before you enter the inside the coach. Stainless steel luggage rack, adequate space to plenty of luggages, and very nicely designed international standards. Inside the coach you have a single aisle, four seater, two on either side, wonderful carpeting, nice upholstery, lot of leg room. And the Vistadomes provide 70% light without actually affecting the inside very much. You can see the Vistadome glass windows up, and to cap it all, the viewing station. It is just beautiful. From here you can have a wonderful view of the surroundings. This is the pantry, and there is a refrigerator, a small microwave oven to heat your food. The seats are like the aircraft one, bottle holders, footrests, charging point conveniently located under the seat. So the seats can be turned 180 degrees, and that's right, that's beautiful. But once you turn the seat, the other seats cannot be turned. So this is the limitation that you have. But the other limitation that you have is some of the seats have got a pillar in the path. Yeah, now you can't transit that here. Very nice. Fire hydrant for safety, and the mirrors have an impregnated switch putting it on and off, and it's a very nice thing. And there's a wash basin, and that's the entrance to toilet, two Western side toilets, sliding door in this compartment in this coach. And inside the toilet, very clean, and again bio toilets and nice mirror with an impregnated light, and an excellent clean neat toilet. What is your first impression?
sewage is very clean. I felt as if I was sitting in a flight.
Did you use the toilet? Did you find it?
I did. They've got an electronic button also which flushes automatically. Good. Hope they'll maintain it in each station. Some of the major stations, they'll come and take care of it.
Thank you, sir. Let's go to the next coach. Automatic doors.
Automatic doors.
Luggage rack. And a different color of the carpet. Push back seats and turned 180 degrees. We are getting ready for departure now.
We have started from Yeshwantpur.
Let's now quickly run to the viewing gallery, which is the last coach. Today our journey starts at Yeshwantpur, Solur, Kunigal, BG Nagar, Chennaraiyapatna, Hassan, and then we have Shakleshpur, that's where the guard section starts, and the guard section ends in Subramanya Road, a distance of 55 kilometers, and then all the way to Mangalore. So that is the view car, which is the last wagon, and now you get a fantastic view of the Yeshwantpur station as we move out of Yeshwantpur. Ticket for this train can be booked on the ICRTC website quite easily, and log in, and then the train is Yeshwantpur Karwa Special 06211, departing on Monday, Wednesdays and Fridays from Yeshwantpur. On other days it is 06575, departing on Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturdays and Sundays. The class of booking is the executive chair car, and the fare is 1395, and there is a normal Shatabdi type AC chair car also available on this train. The fare is 560 rupees. Now we are having breakfast, and then there's a tray that comes out of your side. This thing you can pull out, and then this is for this adjacent seat where you can keep your food trays here, and then you can fold it, and then it goes back into this seat hand. See you after breakfast. After a 3-hour journey, we arrive and depart from a major junction called the Hassan Junction, where the line from Mysore joins. We have departed from Hassan now. This is the viewing coach of the other coach, EB1. We are now arriving at Shakleshpur. This is where the guard section begins. We are arriving after a 4-hour journey, and the local time is 11 o'clock. The stopping time here is about 15 minutes. Nice viewing gallery.
Shakleshpur.
I'm really excited. We'll be going downhill from here, and there are 60 tunnels to negotiate. It's going to be a lot of fun. Stay with me for the next 5 minutes and enjoy the fabulous views of the Western Ghats. We are departing from Shakleshpur, and we have a 55 km ride across the Western Ghats now. Stay with me for some wonderful views, mountain peaks, valleys, railway tracks, curving tracks, waterfalls and whatnot. Enjoy it and I'll talk to you again when we get down. Subramania Road, I think most of the people have got on here, the train is almost empty. SBHR Subramania Road. So how was the ride? Share your comments in the comments column. Subramania Road is
home to Kukki Subramanian temple, a very famous and a popular temple. 180 degree turn seat. We are now crossing the Netravati river, which joins the Arabian Sea south of Mangalore. This is one of the main source of water for both Bantwal and Mangalore districts. The origins of this river are in the Kudremukh area near Chikmagalore, and then it flows south towards Mangalore, and then like any other river takes in tributaries on the way. We are now getting into Mangalore Junction. This is where the lines from Konkan Railway joins the track from Bangalore, and the Konkan Railway continues past to Mangalore Junction and then takes the bypass of Mangalore Central and then proceeds southwards towards Kerala. A lot of information and the links in the description of the video. Please go through them. You can also ask me questions in the comments column and I'll be glad to respond. Thank you very much for watching this video. Appreciate you staying with me, and I look forward to seeing you again in my next video on our journey from Mangalore to Bangalore on the same train. That will be up the hill. Don't miss it. Thank you very much and have a great day.